In an example Meraki network, Meraki's MX devices sit here, looking after routing and security functions. Diving into those features, we start off with routing. Meraki MX devices offer SD-WAN. That's the idea you can load balance over two primary links, and in turn approach MPLS-type performance without the cost and drawbacks of MPLS networks. On top of this, Meraki MX devices offer traffic shaping rules. This is where you can pick how you want certain users or applications to have their traffic traded. Another useful feature is flow preference. This is where you pick which of the two primary links you want certain traffic to flow over. This is typically done for quality of service reasons. MX devices also include unified threat management. That's the idea of rolling next generation firewalls, intrusion detection and prevention, and advanced malware protection all into one single device. Included is also VPN functionality. This is both site-to-site VPN, where you've got two or more sites running two or more MXs, and client VPN, where you've got client devices running the L2TP protocol and don't want to install client software to get a VPN connection. This is available on Mac, Windows, and Linux. Also included is traffic visibility. This is part of the beauty of the Meraki dashboard, the fact there is so much data and visibility into what's going on the network built in. Now, if you do need further visibility into your applications, WAN link performance, or VoIP applications, you can get Meraki Insight. It is an optional software that runs on MX devices to further drill into those applications. Finally, MX devices can help simplify solutions by having things like 4G failover built in with C models, wireless access points built in with the W models, and even some models having power over Ethernet. Now we've covered the features of Meraki MX devices, let's look at actual models. The 60 through 70 series have a desktop form factor and are designed for small branch locations. The 80 through 450 series are designed for larger branch locations and even core networks. Also worth noting are the three virtual MX models. These are designed to route between workloads hosted in public clouds such as GCP, Alibaba Cloud, AWS, or Azure, and your LAN. When deciding on an MX device, it's also good to look at the performance benchmarks. Here, site-to-site VPN throughput and maximum number of client VPNs are typically two of the key features people look at when deciding on an MX. Once suitable hardware has been found, it's then necessary to pick a license. For MX devices, there are three license types: Enterprise, Advanced Security, and SD-WAN Plus. An outline of these features is given on the right, and I will link to that in the description below. On top of that, you also need to pick a license term. That's 1, 3, 5, 7, or 10 years you'd like your MX devices licensed for. It's worth noting that all MX devices in a single dashboard organization must be of the same type. That is, you can't mix Enterprise and Advanced Security. You need to have all Enterprise, all Advanced Security, or all SD-WAN Plus. Once hardware and licensing has been confirmed, it's then necessary to get any accessories. For example, power cables are not included, so you will have to pick those relevant to your location. Finally, for some of the larger models like the MX450, they do have SFP ports, so you will need SFP transceivers to actually transform your fiber to an SFP port. So in summary, when you're designing an MX-based solution, you need hardware, you need licensing, and you need accessories.